Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome to Universal Forum. So hope you people like my video. So today I am come with the topic Coulomb's law. So as we know that Coulomb's law is the force between the two charges. So let's start the Coulomb's law. The first measurement of the force between electric charges. Electric charges means it may be the positive charge or it may be the negative charge. Okay. So positive charges was made in 1874 AB by Charles Coulomb, a French military engineer. On the basis of these measurements, he deduced a law known as the Coulomb's law. Okay, so this is developed by the Charles Coulomb. And then the statement of Coulomb's law, basically this is a force between two charges, and these forces are directly proportional to the magnitude of charge and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay, so if we can say that Q1, this one Q1 and Q2 both are the charges, and this is the distance between them, and if Q1 exert force on Q2, so and Q2 exert force on Q1, so there is a relation between them. So all these relation can be defined in the statement. So that statement known to be the Coulomb's law. Okay, so the mathematical forms is the F directly proportional to Q1, Q2, R squares. So if we remove the proportionality sign, we can use the constant K. Okay, where this F is the magnitude of the mutual force that acts on each of the two point charges Q1 and Q2, and R is the distance between them. This force F is always act along the line joining the two point charges like that. This is the force F1, this is the force. Okay, so where this K is known to be the constant of the proportionality. So when we are talking about the point charges and the distance between them, so it must be noted that there must be all these phenomena must be dependent on the medium. So nature of medium is should be count in the process of counting charges and the forces between them. So let's talk about the nature of medium. Its value depend upon the nature of medium. Between mean K, it say that the K, which is known to be the proportionality constant, which its proportionality constant value depend upon the medium of the nature of the medium between the two charges and system of units in which F, Q and R are measured. Okay, if the medium between two point charges in free space and the system of unit is SI, then K is represented as K equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, with this epsilon naught is known to be the electrical constant, and it is known as the permittivity of free space. So between Q1 and Q2 these two point charges are existed in the free space, where proportionality constant is K, and it can be denoted by this formula. Okay, so in SI unit its value is 8.85 into 10 to power minus 12 newton meter square per coulomb. Okay, so if we substituting the value of this epsilon naught in the question number 2, we get the value K equals to 9 into 10 to power 9 newton meter square into coulomb minus 2. Okay, so thus Coulomb force in free space is putting the value of the K in the question number 1, we get F equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R square. Okay, so this is the equation number 3. So when we're talking about the forces or the forces between two point charges, we must keep in mind that where this whole procedure be done. So it must be noted that it all depend upon the nature of the medium. It means that if we talk about the medium which is known to be the free space, if we say the medium is the if the medium will be the water, will be the water, rubber or paraffin paper, so the values of the K will be different, and also the value of F will be the different. Okay, so let's start again with the Coulomb's force is mutual force. As we know that because of the Q1 and Q2, these they are joining with the distance r, and they are surrounded, and these forces for Q1 exert. So the Coulomb's force is mutual force. It means that if Q1 exerts a force on Q2, then also Q2 exert force on Q1. So which is these forces are equal and opposite force on Q1. It means that we denote this force. If Q2 exert force on Q1, then which can be noted, which can be denoted by the F21, and if Q1 exert force on the Q2, we can denote it with the F12. Then F12 equals to minus F21. Okay, so if we look this picture, see if the Q2 exert force on Q1, it's mean that the force are in the that the force okay are in the that direction, and the position vector are in the direction of the Q2. Okay, so if we look there, if Q1 exert force on Q2, so the force denoted by the F12, and the position vector are in the one in the direction of the Q1. Okay, so the magnitude of both these two of both the forces are in the same and are given in the question number 3. Okay, if we represent the direction of these forces, we introduce a unit vectors. If R21 is the unit vector directed from Q1 to Q2, and R12 is the unit vector directed from Q2 to Q1, then the equation 3 becomes F21 into Q1 Q2 R2 into the R21, and F12 equal to 1/4 by pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 R square into R12. So the question number 5A and the question number 5A are the snake represented the forces snake represented. So the 5A question number 5A and question number 5B shows the direction of the forces. Okay, so next is the forces F21 and F12 are shown in the question number 5A. Question number 5B, it can be seen that R21 equals to minus 1 to R. So the equation that it becomes F21 equals to minus F12. So as you can see the negative sign here. Now we can explain why the negative sign is used in the forces. So sign of charges. The sign of charges in equation number 5A and B determine whether the forces are attractive or whether the forces are the repulsive. Should be, if the two point charges are the positive, then they are the repulsive forces between them. Okay, and if the Q and minus Q, if the one charge, the point charge is positive and the other charge is negative, then the both attract each other. So their sign depend upon their attraction and their repulsion. Now we talk about the effect of medium. We know that the proportionality values of the proportionality constant and the value of the permittivity depend upon the mediums on which the whole process or the point charges are attracted with each other, or maybe they repulse with each other. So the effect of the medium, between the two charges upon the Coulomb force. If the medium is an insulator between the two point charges, and the two point charges are placed on the distance r and exert force on each other, and between them a medium is insulated. So usually we refer this insulator as a dielectric. The presence of dielectric always reduces the electrostatic force as compared with that in free space by a certain factor which is constant for the given dielectric. So this is known as the relative permittivity. It means that whenever insulator is used as a medium between the two point charges and which are exerted force on each other, maybe these two point charges can be attract if each can be attract each other, or maybe they repel each other. So at that moment the electrostatic force will be the less. So because of the given dielectric between them. So at that situation, this is known to be the relative permittivity, and the relative permittivity is represented by the is epsilon r. Okay, this epsilon r. Thus, the Coulomb force in a medium of relative permittivity sigma epsilon r is given by F. We know that this is the formula. For the free space, when this is the epsilon naught is the relative permittivity. When this is only the specific permittivity of the free space. Okay, so when we are talking about the insulator as a medium between the point charges, so we can use this formula F equals to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught epsilon r q1 q2 and r. So this is the equation 6. Hope so people like my videos. So stay tuned with me for the next video. In my next video, I explain the relative permittivity of the different materials and the numerical of the Coulomb's law. So stay tuned with me. Allah Hafiz.